Merry Christmas. Welcome to Calvary on this beautiful Christmas Eve. We are glad that you have joined us for worship tonight as we welcome with mystery and wonder the birth of the Christ child into the world and into our hearts yet again. Whether you are a longtime member or first-time guest, a family member or friend, all are welcome in tonight's worship experience, babies and toddlers included. We are completely okay with the laughter and cries and shuffling about of children of all ages. So if your child cries, there's no need to take them out of the service. We will all experience the barn-like night of Christmas Eve. We do want to extend a special welcome to those of you who are guests, and we invite you to fill out a welcome card to let us know that you are here. You may put that card in the offering plate later in the service. Welcome cards are in the pew rack in front of you, and if you fill one of those out, we will give a gift in your honor to our December monthly mission partner, Kentucky Circle Village. Hopefully, all of the children and the youth and the young at heart either received a crown, a halo, or a shepherd headdress as you came in to worship and some crayons. And we hope everyone received an order of worship and a candle as you came in. If you did not receive one of those items during our time of greeting and our first carol, please feel free to go to the narthex and pick up whatever you need. I will be explaining a little bit later what the ABCs of Christmas is all about, but it's an interactive service, and we want to make sure everybody has what they need beforehand. We have four parts that are left in tonight's program, so if you're willing to read one of our ABCs of Christmas, Morgan and Andrew have those extra parts, and during the time of greeting, just come forward and they will give those to you. And a final note to our children, when we get to the point in the program where we are singing Away in a Manger, you are all invited up to the front steps, and you are going to lead us in singing the first verse of that. So we'll remind you again, but just a heads up. What a gift it is to worship together as we welcome yet again the gift of hope, peace, love, and joy into our lives. Let us stand and greet one another in the spirit of Christmas joy.
Please remain standing as we join in our call to worship based on the prophet Isaiah and the Gospel of John. The impossible is about to happen in a stable. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness. This is the evening when creation stood still and held its breath. This is the evening when God embraced humanity. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, full of grace and truth. Amen.
Let us pray. May the eternal truth be always on our hearts, that the God who breathed this world into being, placed stars into the heavens, is the God who entrusted his life to the care of ordinary people, became vulnerable that we might know how strong is the power of love, a mystery so deep it is impossible to grasp, a mystery so beautiful it is impossible to ignore. Amen.
Tonight, Calvary, we are telling the Christmas story through an interactive script called The ABCs of Christmas. We'll be moving through the alphabet letter by letter, highlighting key characters and themes, and reading scriptures along the way from The Message, which is a contemporary paraphrase of the Bible, as well as singing some beloved carols. Our littlest ones may color the pictures as we go if they wish, and as we move through the service, children and the children at heart who have the headpieces will be the actors in our play, if you will. And so if you chose to be a shepherd, I want you to put on your headpiece if you don't have it on already. Mr. Jack Hagen is your leader tonight. If you're a wise one, make sure you have your crown on. Taylor Goodman is your leader tonight. And Maddie Holst is the leader of the angels. So if you have your halo, that is you. You are an angel. Now, shepherds, wise ones, and angels, as we read through the Christmas story, we need you to listen very carefully. And every time you hear your name, which is shepherd, wise one, or angel, you are to stand up and say a special phrase, and we want you to yell it out loud. So when you hear the word shepherd, all of you who are shepherds will stand up and say as loudly as you can, "Let's go see," and then you'll sit back down. So let's practice. Shepherd.
Let's go see.
Nice. You know, by the end of this, we're gonna have this down really well. Okay, wise ones, every time you hear the word wise ones, you're going to stand up and say as loudly as you can, "Look, a star." So, wise ones.
Look, a star.
Nice, nice. Okay, angels, every time you hear the word angels, you're going to stand up and say as loudly as you can, "Hallelujah." And then you'll sit down. So, let's practice. Angels.
Hallelujah.
Oh, that's beautiful. Your parents can help you follow along in your order of worship. There are little pictures to help along the way, but let's practice one more time. Shepherds.
Let's go see.
Wise ones.
Look,
angels.
Hallelujah.
Y'all are ready. Excellent. Finally, for those of you who received a letter of the alphabet as you came in to read, you or your family will walk to the front at the assigned time and use these microphones. If you need to adjust them, they're very easy. You just grab this here, push in, and pull up or down as you go. We will not prompt you, just come up at the appropriate time. Okay, are we ready to begin? We begin with the letter A.
A is for angel.
Hallelujah!
The angel.
Hallelujah!
Gabriel began the story by telling Mary, "Good morning. You're beautiful with God's beauty, beautiful inside and out. God be with you. Mary, you have nothing to fear. God has a surprise for you. You will become pregnant and give birth to a son and call his name Jesus."
B. B is for Bethlehem, where our story takes place. People traveled far and wide to get to Bethlehem, which was not a very big village. But in that region, by the city, there was shepherds.
Let's go see.
They were watching their flocks.
Thank you. Is for census, which means an official counting of all the people. The census is the reason so many people came to Bethlehem.
D is for donkey. A donkey carried the family on their long journey. Mary and Joseph had to travel 107 miles along the Jordan River to get to from Nazareth to Bethlehem. That is a long journey.
E is for Emmanuel. It is a name special for Jesus. Emmanuel is a Hebrew name that means God with us. It is mentioned in the Old Testament in Isaiah chapters 7 and 8. And in Matthew's gospel in the New Testament. Mary will bring a son to birth, and when she does, you, Joseph, will name him Jesus. God saves, because he will save his people from their sins. This would fulfill what the prophet Isaiah said. Watch for this. A virgin will get pregnant and bear a son. They will name him Emmanuel, Hebrew, for God is with us.
For family. Mary and Joseph and their new baby Jesus created a new family, one that would bless the whole world. The shepherds,
let's go see,
and the wise ones,
look,
were some of the first to greet this family. While they were there, the time came for Mary to give birth. She gave birth to a son, her firstborn. She wrapped him in a blanket and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn.
G is for good news, about to be shared with all the earth. This is what the angels,
hallelujah,
said. There were shepherds,
let's go see,
camping in the neighborhood. They had set night watches over their sheep. Suddenly, God's angel,
hallelujah,
stood stood among them, and God's glory blazed around them. The shepherds,
let's go see,
were terrified. The angel,
hallelujah,
said, don't be afraid. I'm here to announce a great and joyful event that is meant for everybody worldwide. A Savior has just been born in David's town, a Savior who is Messiah and Master. This is what you are to look for, a baby wrapped in a blanket, lying in a manger. At once, the angel,
hallelujah,
was joined by a huge angelic choir singing God's praises. Glory to God in the heavenly heights, peace to all men and women on earth.
H is for hope. Now we light the Advent candle of hope. Hope is knowing that the good news is coming, even when things look bleak. Jesus is the source of our hope.
Story, light the candle of hope. hope.
I is for imagine. If we close our eyes and imagine the scene, we can see the beauty and wonder of the angels.
Hallelujah!
Proclaiming the good news to all men and women, we can see the shepherds.
Let's go see!
First terrified, but then overcome with joy as they heard the good news. We can see the wise ones. Bowing down before Jesus, presenting him with the finest gifts, the first gifts as they experience the good news. If we try even harder, we can imagine a world where God's peace reigns, where there is no war or hunger. And if we can imagine it, we can do it with God's help.
Of joy. Joy is the kind of happiness that comes from God. It cannot be damped and it's always shared. The birth of Jesus gives us joy.
Though Jesus would be king, he was not the kind of king people are used to. Most kings are born in palaces, surrounded by servants. He was born in a stable, surrounded by dirty, smelly shepherds.
Let's go see!
Most kings rule with power and fear. Jesus rules with mercy and love.
It came.
is for love. Now we light the Advent candle of love. Jesus summarized his ministry by saying, love God and love your neighbor as yourself.
Is for manger. A manger is usually used to hold food for animals, but this time it held the baby because it had no crib.
Our children are welcome to come forward now for Away in a Manger. Come just right here to the steps.
Absolutely the very best part of worship. N is for Noel. Noel is another word for Christmas. It means new birth. And that's what happened in our story. That's what happens every year at Christmas. That's what happens every time we decide to follow Jesus. He is born anew in us. The wise ones... Excellent. We're the first to experience the very first Noel.
Seated. O is for offering. The wise ones gave gifts to the baby, and we can offer our gifts every day. We give our time, our talents, and our treasure to God, and we pray that as a church, we are good stewards of all that is entrusted to us. So we share our gifts now.
I gotta take a deep breath. I don't know what to say when I look in your eyes. You made the world before I was born, but here I am holding you in my arms tonight. Could have left us on our own, but you're here. I don't know how long I'm gonna have you for, but I'll be watching when you change the world. look at your hands, they're still so small. Someday you're gonna stretch them out and save us all. Noel, Noel, Jesus, our Emmanuel, you're here. I'm holding you so near. Oh, I'm staring into the face of my Savior, King and Creator. You could have left us on our own, but you're here, you're here. Back on this, the night that God became a baby boy. Someday you're gonna go home again, but you'll leave your spirit and flood the world with joy. You'll be here. We're holding you so near. To the face of our Savior, King and Creator. You could have left us on our own, but you're here. You're here. Hallelujah, you're here.
P is for peace. Now we light the Advent candle of peace. Jesus is the Prince of Peace and is the source of the kind of peace that surpasses our human understanding.
Always with you.
And also with you.
Please stand and share a sign of peace with those around you. God's peace.
Thank you.
is for quiet. We hold silence to remember that when Jesus was born, Mary pondered all that she was feeling in her heart. As the angel,
hallelujah,
choir withdrew into heaven, the shepherds,
let's go see,
talked it over. Let's get over to Bethlehem as fast as we can and see for ourselves what God has revealed to us. They left, running, and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in the manger. Seeing was believing. They told everyone they met what the angels,
hallelujah,
had said about this child. All who heard the shepherds,
let's go see,
were impressed. Mary kept all these things to herself, holding them dear, deep within herself.
Is for reveal. Reveal means showing us something that was once hidden. God reveals to us what love looks like by giving us Jesus. Jesus is love and reveals to us the way to love one another.
S is for star. One special star guided wise ones.
Look, a star!
To come to see the baby. They were mysterious and they lived far away. But they brought gifts to Jesus because they knew that he would grow up to be a king. Instructed by the king, the wise ones,
look, a star,
set off. Then the star appeared again, the same star they had seen in the eastern skies. It led them on until it hovered over the place of the child. The wise ones,
look, a star,
could hardly contain themselves. They were in the right place. They had arrived at the right time. They entered the house and saw the child in the arms of Mary, his mother. Overcome, they kneeled and worshiped him. Then the wise ones,
look, a star,
opened their luggage and presented gifts, gold, frankincense, myrrh.
Thank you.
table.
When Jesus grew up, he invited all to his table. He gave his friends bread and wine and told them to remember him always.
When we gather at the Lord's table, we call it communion because we come together.
U is for unity. Jesus' birth reminds us that we are all called to be one unified body of Christ. Each of us has different gifts, but we use them together to love God and serve others. We need each other. Unity does not mean we're all the same. As unique individuals, we are unified because we are all precious and beloved children of God. As the song we are about to sing reminds us, new life brings new hope and praises. Tonight we wonder, how will Jesus live within us? We long for the day when our country and world has unity instead of strife.
We will open our hearts in prayer to the light of Christ, and after our prayer, I will invite you to join me in the Lord's Prayer as written by Calvary's fifth grade class from the spring of 2015. Let us pray. Almighty God, our light shining in the darkness, we give you the deepest thanks of our heart and the praise of our lips that the light of your love came into the world in the person of your Son, Jesus. God from God, light from light, true God from true God. Through your Son, you created everything that is, seen and unseen. Through the one who came in the form of a vulnerable baby, you gave us life. And through the child who became the Christ, you gave eternal life to all who would believe, body, mind, and spirit. And so on this night of all nights, O God, we say this is good news. Indeed, this is good news of great joy and the best news of all. On this night, for those of us who have grown so familiar with this news that it begins to sound like old news, stir within our hearts a renewed sense of wonder. Astonish us with the gift of your love. Kindle hearts that have grown cold. Help us to feel within our innermost being these good tidings of great joy, that unto us is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. Humble us. Humble us like those shepherds abiding in the field, because the truth is, we have nothing to offer you. We possess nothing that you need. We have no gift to give you that pays you back for the gift that you give us. We are simply blessed beggars, standing in need of your mercy, your forgiveness, your grace. And yet you brought your good news to us. You invited us to celebrate your coming. You made a way for us to become your children. And so on this night of all nights, creating God, hold this moment made of every time, and may we breathe along with all those who have been here before to the heartbeat of hope, and know this moment so full of expectation is as sacred as it gets, because contained here is all the hope of the future and the fulfilling of ancient longing. Receive now the gift of our gratitude and enable us to share this news with others through word and deed, that the whole world may experience this good news for themselves and be transformed by it. We pray this in the name of the one whose coming we celebrate and who taught us to pray in this way, saying, "Our Father, who is in heaven, you are so special. Please make everything good on earth the way it is in heaven. Thank you for our food, and please take care of the hungry. Forgive us when we mess up, and help us forgive others. Keep us out of trouble. You are in charge and love. Amen."
V is for vulnerable. Vulnerable means able to be hurt. Every baby is vulnerable, and so are we when we love one another. God became vulnerable when Jesus was born, and we are called to be vulnerable when we love our brothers and sisters.
For wonder, like the wise ones, we stand in awe and wonder of the newborn King.
Holy night, the stars are bright, be shone. is for Christ. X is the Greek letter chi, the first letter in the word Christ. The X is one of the most ancient symbols of Christianity. People have been using the letter X to stand for Christ for centuries, and now we light the Christ candle, symbolizing the coming of light into the world. Jesus is born.
Y is for you, you angels.
Hallelujah!
You wise ones.
Look, a star.
You shepherds.
Let's go see.
You sons and daughters, you mothers and fathers, you friends and strangers, you are all here to worship and celebrate the birth of Jesus.
Z is for zeal. Let your zeal for Christ burn brightly. As these lights are passed out, know that the light of God burns much, much brighter. Though these lights will die out, the light of God is steadfast and endures forever. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life. And the life was the light of all the people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it.
The Gospel of John proclaims boldly that the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. I invite those who were baptized in 2016 to come forward. They are going to help us light our candles tonight. When people are baptized here at Calvary, we place salt on their lips and say, "You are the salt of the earth." And then we hand them a candle saying, "You are the light of the world. Go now and shine your light brightly." This is what we are doing tonight, friends. We are sharing our light with the world. After our candles are lit, we'll be hearing a song called Peace, Peace, which will lead us into the singing of Silent Night and into Joy to the World. As the light comes to your pew, please tilt your unlit candle to the upright lit candle to receive the light. This will prevent any wax from falling on you.
Thank you.
you go into the darkness of this Christmas night, let your light shine. And may you be filled with the wonder of Mary, the obedience of Joseph, the joy of the angels, the eagerness of the shepherds, the determination of the Magi, and the peace of the Christ child. Amen.